I'm Emily Fortuna.
And I'm Andrew Fitzgibbon.
And today we're going to be implementing compensating actions, the compensating actions design pattern with Temporal in Java.
Yes. And then hopefully after we get that done, we'll see some other stuff too. But we're going to start there, see how it goes.
Yes. So for those of you that do not know, the reason you might want to do compensating actions is because in a world of distributed systems, we've got, you might have some activity happening on one machine, and then you need to call out to another machine, another service. And what if that goes down?
Mm-hmm.
And the more important part is, like, what if whatever you're doing, you need to kind of roll back if there's a problem. Maybe you're handling money, and so if you deposit the money and then this disappears,
right,
you got a problem.
Exactly. And if I imagined doing that just on my own, more or less manually, there's a lot of detail to take care of there, right? In order to make sure I don't undo something that's already undone or do something that's already been done or vice versa, whatever.
Yeah, so in Java with Temporal, it's pretty easy. Right now, I have a very basic Java Temporal app. If you're not familiar with Temporal, basically we've got... Do we want to go through this?
Let's do it real quickly.
Okay, yep. Real quickly, lightning round. You've got your workflow, which is like your logic of your program. And the workflow calls out to individual activities. These activities are like where the meat and potatoes of the action of your program is. The workflow is just kind of directing the logic. And so we're going to be doing our development in the workflow because mm-hmm. we'll say, like, if this activity failed, then we will undo it.
Yeah. I like to think of them as the simple API call that's going to actually commit the action you're trying to do, like booking a hotel, for example.
100%. So, today we are not going to be booking a hotel. We are going to be making breakfast.
Excellent. I love breakfast. Favorite meal of the day.
So, in terms of breakfast, I wrote up, so I have this, I've written up the activities. So, we've got our, activity interface here. We have getting the bowl, we have adding cereal, and then adding milk. Those are the three like main steps. And then we have some compensations that are, you can put the bowl away. We have a put stuff your cereal back into the box.
I do that every time I have breakfast.
Yes.
Let's be honest.
I did not implement put milk back in because at that point, you're kind of already committed.
The milk's already been spilt.
Yes, the milk is saturated, the cereal is done with. You've committed to making breakfast. So, those are three pieces. Bowl, cereal, milk, and then we can compensate. You can have compensations for every single step in this particular case, since it's a real-world example.
Are there cases where I wouldn't need a compensation? I guess the milk is a good example, potentially.
Yeah, totally. Well, here's an example, actually. Say one of your activities is sending an email.
Okay. Yeah.
You can't really take
it. That's a great example. Yeah. No, once it's out, it's out.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Sorry. So, yeah.
Okay.
There's definitely other cases.
So, things that are definitely one way, or like maybe I'm writing out to a dead letter log of something that's happened, or sending an email, which it's already happened.
It's hoped.
Yep. So, things that you can't actually compensate for, then don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Like
or...
the milk. You can't put it back in.
Exactly. Exactly. Cool. So to implement this in our workflow, there's this Saga library that is built into Temporal. And so we're going to make use of that to hold the compensations and then we'll just ask it to compensate when we're done. So, let's first just type up our activities. So we have our breakfast activity instantiate here.
Mm-hmm.
So breakfast activity, and we'll say Gibble.
Okay.
And first, I'm just going to write out the steps here. Breakfast activity.
So this is our high level workflow, just the basic. What are we going to do to eat breakfast? Make breakfast.
And oops, first. I mean, some people
do. Well, okay, yeah, that's a debate here. Cereal first or milk first, but...
In this video, we're coming down hard.
Cereal first.
This is the correct order. It has been said. We may be having a guest come.
Yep.
At some point. Okay, so we've got that. Now, we want to add the undo steps.
Okay.
Now, you might think you want to add your undo step after you get your bowl.
Right, I do the thing first, and if it fails, undo it.
Yes. However, what if you, you're doing your, you execute your get bowl thing, and you haven't yet, so there is a log that's saying, like, I have executed get bowl.
Okay.
Let's say we write to that log to execute that log after the bowl has been gotten. What if we crash in between getting the bowl but before we have written to the log?
So now the bowl is gotten, but...
But it, our thing doesn't know.
Then it's just gotten and it's never put back or anything.
Yes, and we don't want plates on the counter.
Nope.
Bad.
Yes. Clean up after ourselves.
Exactly. We have a tidy house here. So, so you want to put your compensation first.
Right, so that we guarantee it's in the log of things that should happen
if something goes wrong.
Right, okay.
But that does mean your compensation needs to be aware that it could execute and there's actually no bowl there. Because, like, if we crash before we record the bowl...
Oh, I see. Yeah, and so then if we try to put the bowl back, but it's already, I don't know, been put back, or it wasn't actually successfully taken, what are we putting back?
A little funkiness there.
Okay.
But breakfast activity dot, and that's why we have put bowl away if present.
If present, I like that.
And then breakfast activity, put cereal back.
So how do I know if I'm putting the same bowl away?
Well, that is a good question that I did not implement in this API. In this API, there is only one bowl in the house.
Great. it's my favorite bowl.
Yes. It's the only bowl. Oh, so sad. But in a real world application, you might have a ID. Like, so there's this notion of item potency.
Right.
ID or key. And basically that's like for this sequence, for this, these events, this is sort of like a, I almost want to call it a password. It's not a password, but it's like a, it's a key.
Identifier.
Yeah. ID, key, reference. To say that this is the bowl that I'm talking about. This is the transaction that I'm talking about. This is the sequence of events I'm talking about.
Yeah. So if we were talking about a, if instead of a bowl, it's a bunch of money we're pulling from an account. Maybe it's the ID that represents that transaction.
Yep. 100%.
Great.
Okay. And so like you could pass in, a int string, whatever, a unique ID into this make breakfast workflow.
And then use that as the key throughout.
And then we just check. We like say, hey, has this been, has this key been written to the thing? If so, then don't.
Got it.
Don't
cool.
do the thing. Yeah, exactly. Thank you for asking. Great. So we've got all this stuff. But like, we don't want this to actually, we don't want this to always run.
Yeah, right, right. Because what if the bowl is successfully gotten and now we have cereal in it? Or are we putting it away and then before we put cereal in, et cetera?
So this doesn't actually make sense here. So first of all, these compensations are going to happen in the face of failure. So we're going to wrap this in a try catch block.
Yep.
So try accept. Oh. There we go. Like I said,
which language are we in?
Yes, exception E. And so this Saga library has a compensate function.
Ooh.
And just tell it to do the thing. Now there's a little bit more to it, but first, so we'll just say throw, just so that you can know what the actual exception is when this actually happens, but your compensations have been taken care of.
Yeah.
So now, though, we're still executing these things. That's we don't want this. We want to register this function with our Saga library so it knows to execute.
Yeah, so I noticed in the autocomplete when you're doing that, there was an add compensate. Is that what we're looking for?
100%.
Oh my gosh, looking ahead.
Thanks, Fitz.
You're welcome.
So we want to say add compensation, and we're going to just say put bowl away. Whoa, let's just copy.
Is it from the activity? Breakfast activity dot?
Oh, okay. Yep, there we go. Thank you. Okay, so
right.
Java syntax. Sometimes I forget Java.
Java.
Okay, whew.
Okay, so that.
Okay. And that's all there is to it.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
We can run it.
Okay.
To show you what's what. So, let's go to Java. I should have cleared my screen. Okay, so in my handy little README, first we build.
Wait for Gradle to do its thing.
Then we start up our workflow itself. Cool. And now we start the worker.
Okay.
To do the work.
Yep.
To ask the worker, what do I need to do? So currently, this has no failures. So you can see getting goal
through
blah,
successfully.
Blah. Cool.
Done.
So that means I put the things in the right order. But now to check for failure, we can just throw
like
something.
Have the get bowl or add milk or something throw an error.
Yes. Throw exception.
And does it matter? Well, I guess it doesn't matter here what we're throwing, since the catch you have in the workflow is just a generic catch.
Yes. Yes, there was exception. Yes, okay, so we've had our failure.
Okay.
I'm gonna kill this. I don't need to restart that. I think I can just do this. Do I need to kill the other thing?
Might need to
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Might need to do the Gradle build and the initiator. Yes. And then the worker again, all three steps.
Need to kill that other
workflow.
Yes. Oh.
Nope. Already finished.
Okay. Build. Initiate generation.
Go. Worker. We should see then the compensating.
Yes. Okay. So, let's look at what happened. We did the steps.
Yep.
We had a fail.
Yep, that's our runtime.
We put the cereal back in the box, and we put the bowl away.
Okay.
In the order that we wanted them to compensate.
Ah, so we did this. So since we added the compensation for the putting the cereal back first or second, then that's going to happen first. So we're doing it in reverse order.
Yep, exactly. So where is my workflow? Yep. So it goes from here back up.
Last in, first out.
100%. If we don't care about the order, in this example we do, obviously, but if we don't, we can set parallel compensations to true, so we can do this to true, and then these could execute in any order.
Yeah. Cool.
Yes. So, there you have it. Thank you for tuning in with...
Compensating Actions
with Temporal in Java. See you next time.